Okay. In the meantime, let's start on the bread. That's gonna be this tray, this bread, and this knife. I don't want to make the whole bread. So, this bread goes back in here. I'll make a sandwich out of this bread later. First of all. In you go. Alright. Cut the bread open. So, we have cheese, garlic, butter, parsley, my salt and pepper that I pre-measured out. Now, I'm gonna heat up the butter. I'm just gonna use the same dish because this is just butter and oil. Seems like a lot of butter, but that's what they said. There's already some garlic in here, so I'm actually not gonna use... I'm gonna use the whole thing. I'm gonna wait till this melts a little before I put in these two. Melt this enough, put it into a paste, put it onto the bread, and then we're gonna leave that to the very end, but I want it to soak in, so there we go. Melty butter. Keep it on low heat, just enough the butter to melt. I don't want to burn or cook anything, really. Okay, I'm gonna start adding in the cheese. If it looks like I know what I'm doing, then that's acting, because this is the first time I've ever attempted anything. All I did was look this up online. Parsley, cheese, now the picture online did not look like this. So, just pointing that out there. This is a lot more watery than I think it's supposed to be. I think I used too much butter. I could reduce this down if I keep cooking it until the butter kind of melts away, but I don't want to do that. So, let's start lathering. I'm gonna use my little spatula. This looks like it's gonna be way too intense garlic bread. Like, it's a good thing that my boyfriend is not coming over tonight, because he would not want to be within 10 feet of me. Alright. See, the fact that I can scoop it like this probably is not good. Let's just pour it, see what happens. Garlic bread. Okay. See, some recipes for garlic bread called for... Oh, see, now it's melting in there, so I can just kind of do that. Oregano. But since I saw that I was gonna eat parsley for something else that I'm making tomorrow, I looked up a recipe that called for parsley, which is this. And the truth is, parsley, garlic, and butter mixed together just is slamming. No one can deny that. So, here you go. That's all in there. We're gonna put this on a plate. Need something. What's it need? Need salt. Oh shit, I forgot the salt and the pepper. Son of a whore. Oh, well that's weak sauce. I was supposed to put this in the mixture. And a tiny bit of pepper. Cooking faux pas. Now let's put this to the side. And we're back. The chicken is cooking. The water is starting, I'm heating the water for the pasta, which I'm just gonna make some angel hair. Just a little. I've left this butter melting here in room temperature, and I'm heating it now. We're just gonna saute. It's kind of a bit too much butter. So I'm putting butter, I'm putting some garlic, some of the garlic that I minced because I have too much garlic in the house. We're gonna put some dried parsley, and we'll let that go for a little bit. Again, my disclaimer, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I peeled and deveined these shrimp. I just left the little tail on because I like the little tail. And I'm just gonna saute them in here. In this garlic parsley mixture. Now, I've done this before, only with garlic powder and butter. This is my first time using minced up garlic and my first time ever using any kind of green in this. So I'm gonna leave that on low. And for shits and giggles, I'm gonna spray some oregano on the top. And let that go. It's gonna get nice and orange and it'll be delicious. So we have the, oh God, there's so much garlic in here, my eyes are itching. So we have the second batch of shrimp here. They're cooking. We have the angel hair, very little. I only put a little. And I think the chicken's done. I think I might have actually overdone it a bit. I wasn't really paying attention. But that's fine. Oh, chicken. Oh crap, was I supposed to flip it? You know what, I don't know. I might have was supposed to flip it. Might have was supposed to. So I'm going to cut a piece and check it out. Oh, chicken's done. Done. Good. Actually, near perfect. So I'm going to move you back here. Good. Keep sauteing you. Are you still recording? Yes, you are. So, next step, I'm gonna move this here, and we're gonna put you on broil. It's gonna get hot in this bitch. Alright, let's say it's enough. In goes the garlic bread. Now this you gotta watch, because that might burn. The angel hair is almost ready. Thinking of not using tomato sauce for the angel hair. We'll see. Maybe I'll just use a butter sauce. I love butter. You see how much butter I've used today? I love butter. I love salt. If I keel over from a heart attack, I think this video would be evidence. Small one is for shrimp. Yep, we're good. Shrimp, and shrimp. Alright. That's done, we're just waiting on you. Like I said, I was only going to make a little bit of angel hair, and I really made a little bit. Like, really little. Probably should have made a bit more than that. That's all I got. Serving for one. For the angel hair, I'm just going to toss with a little bit of tomato, basil, garlic. A tiny bit of the Parmesan cheese. Ooh, too much. Oh, I had the fan on.
See the wind come to
you are done, 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 done. I'm running out of room here. There we go. Ooh, broiler hot. Alright, turn it off. Open the window a bit.
So, there we go. So, this is our final product. We have garlic chicken. I have just a little bit of angel hair, a little bit of butter, a little very light butter sauce. Now, the garlic bread, which is over here, I apparently use way too much parsley because it almost looks like it's garlic bread with pesto, but it's not. And then, of course, we have the garlic shrimp, which I can't wait to eat. So, there you go. And bon appetit.